Cadence, our little girl, was born February 23rd, 2007. She was 5 months old when we went on a family vacation. We all got sick, very, very, very sick. And we came home from vacation and Cadence had a really soft cry. And every time I'd lay her down, I noticed that she would kind of cry, which was not like her. I called the doctor's office and the doctor came in and she said, "Cadence looks great." I said, "I know, but there's something wrong." And just then, like a light switch got flipped on, Cadence started coughing. A terrible, terrible cough. I had never heard something like that before. And the doctor just said, "Wow, has she been doing this?" And I said, "No."
I just remember getting a phone call and my wife in tears saying that we've got to go up to Primary Children's. Her heart's so large, it's blocking her left lung.
She had to be admitted to the pediatric intensive care unit. She had IVs placed and had to be on medication through her IV to help her heart squeeze. She eventually had to be on a breathing machine. And then towards the end of October, it was clear that her heart function was continuing to decline.
Dr. Everett came to me and said, "We really need to list Cadence for her heart. We've talked about it briefly, but we really need to have the talk now." We tried to hold her off as long as we could. I got a phone call from Mike on a Sunday morning from the hospital, and he was crying, and he told me that Cadence was really sick, and that the doctors didn't know if she would make it through the day.
The thought of losing her was very, very difficult, and it was a very hard time emotionally to be able to face the thought of losing the, you know, our only daughter and such a sweet one at that.
She had been listed for heart transplant. There were no donor organs available. So in order to give her a longer period of time to live while waiting for an organ, we started to investigate our ability to put in this device. It's a ventricular assist device known as the Berlin Heart. This particular device was developed in Germany. The FDA allows us to get compassionate use and experimental use for the device in individual cases.
So we got the equipment in from Berlin, Germany. The doctors flew in to help do the procedure, and Cadence was given the Berlin Heart on November 7th.
It was a night and day difference. We had a daughter that was a little bit gray, was completely immobile, to a girl that was pink, full of life and full of energy. We had our daughter back. I mean, we could hold her again. It was a great day when she got the vet.
She handled the Berlin Heart really well. In December, probably about the second week of December, Cadence started getting sick again. And the right side of her heart was now starting to fail. We knew that there was a chance that they would have to go in again and do a procedure and put another Berlin Heart on the right side of her heart. And I worried about it for probably a day. And then I got an overwhelming feeling and I knew Cadence's heart was coming. Hello?
Chantel, this is Emily.
No way.
It's always a mixed reaction, and because I have children myself, and you know that when a donor heart is available, that there's another family who had a tremendous tragedy. But it's also such a joyful occasion because you're the physician of that patient that is now going to receive this precious gift and have the ability to be a normal child again.
I was jumping up and down and screaming with joy, and at the same time I was crying for the poor family that lost their child to be able to save mine.
They gave Cadence a future. They gave us hope. They gave her brothers or sister. They gave her mom and dad their only daughter.
It was the greatest gift that I think can ever be given. And it was truly just extremely bittersweet. One of the things that helped us cope the most was the love and caring of the people around us in our family and in our community, and even the family that we have up at Primary Children's. I swear they love my daughter as much as I do.
Miracles happen, and these children's hospitals are what they are because of the communities around them.
I see the heart from a physiology standpoint and the impact it has on life, but the symbol of a heart is much more than that. It also symbolizes love. Out of love is where giving comes in.
When someone donates to Primary Children's or the Children's Miracle Network, they're giving these children a chance to have a future.
For our hospital and our physicians and medical staff to do what they need to provide the care for these patients, it does take many people giving of their time, giving of their love, and giving of their money.
I was given this heart at Christmas after Cadence was transplanted with the heart that was given to us. And all the lines through it represent all the people that have woven themselves to come together to support our family, to help get Cadence her heart.